came through with the real flow. Signing out, ES News, Andy Emilio, and why?
Rio 2016 representing Ireland, looking to stay undefeated as a pro, 4-0, 4-KOs, Michael Johnson.
It's funny,
good, bro.
What's up, my man?
Chilling, man. Ain't shit. Same old, same old. How's everything with you, man?
Good, man. January 20th.
January 20th, right on that Spence card, right?
It ain't about that, man. It's about my brother right now.
Yeah, man.
I mean, he gonna go out there, do his thing.
What's something we don't know about Shakur behind the scenes?
As a fighter or as a person?
Both, either one.
If he can't beat you and you don't give him a chance to beat you, he ain't messing with you.
So he's real competitive.
Basically. Right? If somebody beat you and they don't give you a chance to beat them back, they with it.
Johnny Haynesworth, first on the scale. I have a good corner tomorrow from Philadelphia.
So, Rigondeaux had Lil B-Hop helping him spar. Loma had Shakur. Yeah. And then that's maybe a future fight down the line itself. A big one, right?
That's definitely a future fight.
So, like, just to see these two young superstars here like that, that's kind of crazy, isn't it? I mean, I know you guys got to kind of maybe go back and forth. Have you and B-Hop gone back and forth a little bit? Like, nah, my guy's going to be your guy since you guys both helped. You helped Loma and he helped Riggo.
I
mean, like,
we just gonna sit back and watch. I think he going with Rigondeaux.
Yeah, obviously, yeah.
I ain't got no pick.
Oh, you ain't got no pick. Oh yeah, so
we just kicked.
Okay, so you're just impartial.
Like I said, we just kicked in the candy shop.
Yeah,
that's it. That's all that is.
So.
140 division, man. I know your boy. Oh, there he is. There he is, right there. That, I was just gonna bring him up. He's always commenting on your IG pics.
Me, I look better.
It's a thing between you and who's lighter.
Man, I'm so better.
Who's lighter?
Oh my God! You mad ugly, bro.
Don't talk to that man.
We got something for you.
What y'all doing? Y'all playing ball later? Y'all hooping?
I had to meet a little bit closer.
Because I know you've been saying it every chance you get that you've been busting his ass in ball.
I like this jacket.
Yeah.
He's a barber.
Last night we heat up in ball.
Yeah. B-Hop was turning up.
Huh?
That's the one that does the shorts?
So I was talking to Shakur, saying if you guys were going back and forth a little bit, like, yo, Riggo's gonna beat Loma. Nah, Loma's gonna beat Riggo, because I know your team Riggo at the end of the day.
Nah, we wasn't going back and forth for what?
Just joking around type shit, you know.
We're gonna sit back and watch the fights. And made the best man win, but I'm going for Team Riggo. You know how that is.
How does that work, man? I know there's a lot to learn. Huh?
Ask me the same thing every time. How does it work?
You gotta tell me, man. Everybody's not listening. Everybody doesn't know. This is a world-class elite fighter.
It's sparring, dude. It's sparring fights. It's two different things. So sparring can go one way, and a fight can go a whole different, another way.
What's the power like?
Riggo?
Yeah.
Yeah, he got power. I told you about it. He got power. Yeah.
All right. Everybody's making a big deal that Loma's so much bigger than him. Will that be a big deal?
No. Riggo now done for somebody that was 5'10".
I think a lot of fans have. Because at every weigh-in and every face-off, Riggo's always been the shorter guy against Donaire or all these guys.
He's just a short guy.
But he has real power in that left hand. What about this guy right here, man?
Oh, that's my son?
I know you guys were having lunch. You kept calling him your son. What's the relationship with Bud that you got?
Father and son relationship. That's my son. Father.
So sad.
Like, so I guess
I took him to basketball.
So I guess that's the grandfather.
I took him to play basketball last night. Took him to play basketball. We had fun last night. You know?
What's Bud's skill set in ball?
Father,
so we got father, son, and grandfather. Come on, grandpa, get in here too.
Man, stop! Don't act up in here. Don't act up in here. Don't act up in here, brother.
Africa. Do you want to take a picture? Yeah, let's take a picture.
Thank you. You see, I see them for years and I never take a picture with them.
You never hold your tongue, bro. You've been telling me for a while now that Bud beats Errol Spence.
That's a fact.
And now he's there at 147. That's the super fight everybody wants. Do you want to see him against Spence first, or you want to see him against Thurman first?
It don't matter. It don't matter. Against who?
Against Thurman, because that's the one that he wants the most.
It don't matter. Anybody. I mean, he train hard, he work hard, and he want to keep proving himself on every level. So
people are wondering if he has the size.
You mean, do we have the power?
Well, I mean, from 135 to 147.
Do they have the power?
Because, you know, Keith's thing is, you know, a true welterweight. Keith considers himself the bigger man. You know, he started at 152, worked his way down to 147.
Terrence Crawford knocked the fuck out.
He got pound in both hands. We see it. This ain't no act.
Is he your pound for pound number one fighter in the game today? That's your pound for pound number one guy right there?
Right now?
Yeah.
Yeah, definitely. You know I beat his ass, man.
You know, the fight everyone wants to see is him and Spence.
Yeah.
Lil Beehive, you know, he got Bud all the way.
Yeah.
How do you have that? I know you might be a little...
I don't got no prediction. Kid in the candy shop.
Great fight?
I know both guys, so I don't, even though I'm close with Bud, I don't want to make a prediction like that.
Yeah.
So, I'm going to get in here.